This is the OG in the dog pound coming to you live from Asia. This is Crypto Daily Trade Signals coming to you live with another barn burner of a video. We're going to talk about how Jeff Bezos is trying to stop Elon Musk and Dogecoin going to the moon, guys. Jeff Bezos is trying to stop Elon, trying to stop the Doge going to the moon, guys. Evil Jeff is trying to stop us. We're going to talk about that, and I'm going to give you my opinion on what's going to unfold. I'm going to talk about NASA, I'm going to talk about the moon, and I'm going to talk about Dogecoin to the moon, guys, and literally going to the moon, and not just going to $1, which we absolutely will get there soon, but I'm going to talk about Dogecoin literally going to the moon, and how that's going to affect, and how we're going to stop Jeff Bezos from allowing Elon Musk to take a physical Dogecoin to the moon, how we're going to stop Jeff Bezos from actually allowing Elon to start mining Doge on the moon, guys. Woo, let's jump into it right now. We're going to talk about Bitcoin price. We're going to talk about Dogecoin price. We're going to talk about some breaking news when it comes to regulations. We're going to talk a little bit about Tether. You guys need to buckle up and watch the video from start to finish. Do not drop off. I expect every single person that if you're going to watch this video, watch to the end. And if you're not going to watch to the end, do not watch this video. All right, watch to the end. Before that being said, I need to say a couple of things. Remember, this is not financial advice. This is only the OG in the house offering my opinion. Remember, I'm not a licensed financial advisor, and in no way can this be construed or taken as financial advice, okay? This is for educational purposes only, and it's for your education, and it's my opinion. And don't forget to watch out for NASA scammers in the contents. They're using bots, and every time my videos come out, the bots just go boom, they descend on the video, and they make comments and crazy comments, and they're gonna pretend to be me, look like me, use my logo, and they're gonna ask you to contact them via WhatsApp. Seems to be the main way to contact. Don't do that. I'm never going to ask you in the comments to contact me. All right? Don't do it. One last thing. If you are a super member, a paid super member, you need to send me an email right now so we can send you the private link. All right? The email is right there. You need to send me an email right now. This is only for bona fide super members only, not channel support members, but super members only. Send me an email, and then our marketing person, Jenny Tong, will reach out to you and give you that private link. We have a whole bunch of people in the group offering all sorts of tips, tricks, sharing data, and this and that. So you guys definitely want to get into that. And don't forget to go back and check some of my other amazing videos. You know, we're expecting insane Dogecoin price movements very soon, and so let's buckle up, just jump into the content. All right, let's get. So right now we're seeing my Bitcoin right now is at 40,523. It's starting to turn green now. We had in Asia, we had the last candle. It's been red for most of the day. We've been kind of going sideways right now. So that's a little bit of consolidation. After we went to a high of 40,800, we almost went to 41,000. There's been a little bit of sell-off today in Asia, but I think most of the sell-off has been done, and now we're seeing ourselves going back up again. Now we have this pink line here, and this pink line is 40,750. We really need to get above that, stay above that. That's really key. Now if you look at this orange line here, this is a 200-day moving average. Remember, this is a one-day chart, Binance one-day chart. Remember, on CoinMarketCap, the prices may be different because CoinMarketCap uses the aggregate of all the exchanges, but this is a Binance exchange price that we're looking at right now. So right now we're at 40,568, and of course it's constantly moving because crypto never sleeps, crypto never dies, it's always moving. I'm climbing the wall. So this is like the 16th or 17th day of lockdown. I can't remember, I'm going crazy. We got overcast skies, it's gonna rain anytime soon, so if you start seeing raindrops falling on my head, then you know it's raining, and I'm gonna have to skedaddle and go inside because I don't want my computer getting wet. So it's looking pretty positive, but this 200-day moving average, we need to break past that, and right now my 200-day moving average is around about 44,700. I think we can break that you know, probably by Monday or Tuesday. Remember, Monday to Friday, the markets pump, and then Saturday and Sunday, markets tend to dump. But recently, we're seeing greener days on the weekend and redder days on the weekday. So let's see how that pans out, guys. Let's jump into Medoji Doge. So, you know, Doge should be moving up. Well, Doge is still kind of just going sideways right now. Similar pattern as Bitcoin, and most of the altcoins right now are not—they're not losing ground. They're just kind of going a little bit sideways right now. So that's pretty good. You can see here that this is a four-hour. This is on the daily chart. Yesterday, we hit a high of. Let me get that out of there. So yesterday we hit a high. Get out of here. What's going on here? Technical troubles. OG's having technical troubles. So yesterday we hit a high of around about 21.8 here, and then yesterday we hit a high of 20.0206. So right now we're trading at 20.44. So really, guys, there's really been, I would say, there's no movement. Absolutely no movement is happening. So I wouldn't panic. This is a good sign. When we have sideways action consolidation without any volatile ups and downs, this is a good sign. And this is just a brief consolidation before we end up going higher to the upside. All right, guys. So I wouldn't panic so much. So this is the 20-day moving average, which we definitely have gone past. We have the 50-day moving average on the one day time frame. We're gonna blow past that. I'm pretty confident we're gonna do that. So guys, we're looking okay. Doge is looking okay. Doge is performing in line with what Bitcoin is doing, and that's what we really want, guys. So let's take a look on the 4-hour chart. Let me get that out of there. That's the Aurochs tool. So you can see here on the 4-hour chart, we're actually getting a little bit of a green candle on the 4-hour chart. So you can see on the 4-hour chart, we had a high of 20.0205, and we had a low of 0203. So we're kind of range bound between that. So basically, it's kind of a nothing burger right now. I mean, I wouldn't pay too much attention to it. Don't panic. Turn off your computers. We're not having any really major movement. So that's really good news, guys. So let's jump into a couple of news articles, and then we're going to jump into the big story. How Jeff Bezos is going to try to stop Elon Musk and try to stop Dogecoin from going to the moon, guys. So literally, Dogecoin going to the moon. And we still got the angry granny out there, Elizabeth Warren, screaming up a storm. Bitcoin is bad, crypto's bad, blah, blah, blah. So we still got them screaming up a storm, so I wouldn't pay too much attention to that. So let me get my face out of the way. I know you guys don't like to see my face, my beautiful face. Carlos, if you're listening to this, Carlos, one of our huge fans, he keeps bugging me, saying, "Darm, can you sing the Purple Rain?" So you can see, here's the purple trend line. We're blown past that. So purple rain line. So that's a purple rain line, guys. So Carlos, if you're listening, better be smashing the likes, buddy. And that just goes to everyone. If you're watching this, don't forget to smash the likes. Subscribe if you haven't. Smash. So right now, this is really good news. It's kind of a positive news. Bitcoin Strategy Pro Fund aims to tackle regulatory barriers for investors. Because, you know, a lot of investors, you know, they don't want to hold Bitcoin in wallets. They don't want to actually trade on crypto platforms. They want to have really kind of, I would say, a retail, you know, kind of stocks experience to buying crypto. They don't want to get into all this wallets and exchanges, and they just want to be able to like call their broker and say, "Hey, Mr. Broker, I want to have this much on Bitcoin." So this really facilitates that. It's fully regulated, fully licensed. So this will really help the people who are just kind of like lazy investors who just want to like have everything done for them. You know what I mean, right? So mutual funds provider ProFund aims to enable crypto exposure for investors without actually buying Bitcoin. So that's a good thing, because any exposure to Bitcoin is a good thing. Any more liquidity in the market is a good thing, all right? So the United States-based, and this is a US-based form, it's not some Brazilian or some South American or some banana republic somewhere, you know, in Timbuktu that nobody's ever heard of. This is in the US, so it's good. So and hopefully the SEC, once they see this fund going in, they're gonna start approving more Bitcoin ETFs, because that doesn't seem to be happening. I don't know what's going on. The SEC, they're scared. They're too busy listening to Yellen and Warren, you know, and the angry nanny has nothing to do with oversight on crypto, so I don't know what she's yelling about. But anyways, United States-based investment management firm ProFunds announced the launch the launch of a Bitcoin strategy pro fund, and the ticker is BTCFX, so you can probably check that out. One of the first publicly available mutual funds or ETFs that performs in parallel with Bitcoin, all right? So it's pegged against Bitcoin. Hello, what's going on? And hello. So that would be an interesting coin, huh? It's pegged in parallel. So it's pegged, right? So Pro Fund provides an alternative to the trading methods of holding cryptocurrency via wallets or crypto exchanges with this service. Like I said, a lot of particularly older people, they don't want to be joining Binance and KYC, and they don't quite understand it, right? So this is kind of a really easy mom and pop, the grandma grandpa kind of, how do you get into Bitcoin? Well, call ProFund. They got a fund here. So, and then basically what they're saying, compared to directly buying a Bitcoin, which may involve opening a new account with unregulated party, ProFunds offers investment opportunity to gain exposure to Bitcoin through a form and investment method that tens of millions of investors are familiar with, right? So it's basically an ETF. It's a mutual fund kind of thing, and everybody knows that. It's kind of old mutual fund. Oh, so it's kind of good for the grandmas and the grandpas out there. Maybe Elizabeth Warren, maybe she'll even sign up to the BTC FX fund. Oh, okay. Maybe we should send her some. And then when she starts making a ton of money on Bitcoin vis-a-vis the fund, maybe she'll put a sock in her mouth and stop complaining about crypto when she's starting to make a ton of money. So some other news. Right now, market wrap, Bitcoin is expected to pause before the next rally. And that's exactly what it's doing. Bitcoin is just kind of pausing. It's kind of going sideways. So a lot of people are expecting that. Bitcoin buyers are in a profit-taking mode as the cryptocurrency tests the 40,000 resistance level. So sentiment has significantly improved, guys. And we've really seen that sentiment is really, really improving now. And that's really good news over the past week. Although some analysts think it's time for a pause before another leg. Yeah, there might be a pause, and if there's going to be a pause, in my opinion, I think there's going to be a pause between 38,000 and 40,000, if there's going to be a pause, and it's going to be kind of sideways, moving between 38,000 and 40,000 before we get our next big breakout. But we really need to stay, as I said, guys and gals, we really need to stay above this 40,750 mark, and we need to stay above that for at least 1 or 2 days to confirm that. Otherwise, we're going to be range bound between 38,000 and 40,000 before we have our next leg up. And our next big resistance level is at 50,000. I think that's going to be pretty easy. And if we can hit 50,000, then for the Doge to go up to 50 cents, I think is pretty easy peasy Japanese lemon squeezy. So we're going to get it. So here's the big story, guys. Buckle up. So our dear friend Jeff Bezos, if you're listening, I got your name wrong. So Jeff Bezos. So if Jeff Bezos, he doesn't like Elon. He never liked Elon because, they're competing to be, they're competing in the space race. Jeff was the first guy to go up basically they so-called go to outer space. Hello. And basically going to outer space means that you go up and you're weightless for like 1 or 2 minutes and you come back down. For me, that's not going out of space. So as Jeff Bezos, he's crying up a storm. He wrote a letter to NASA and said, please consider our company, allow us to build the lunar landers. And I don't think it's fair that Elon Musk got the sole contract. And to sweeten the deal, I'm Jeff Bezos, and I'm going to give NASA $2 million, and if you can kind of eliminate Elon Musk. Well, here's the thing. NASA has signed a contract with SpaceX, okay? So NASA is not going to back out of the contract with Elon Musk. That's not going to happen because Elon is not in breach. SpaceX is not in breach of any contract. They haven't violated anything. So for NASA to terminate the contract retroactively because Jeff Bezos is offering $2 million, that's not going to happen because SpaceX would sue the bejesus out of NASA. NASA's not going to do that. I really think that, the open letter that Jeff Bezos sent to NASA administration Bill Neeson said that the company is producing a safe and sustainable lander and will return Americans to the surface of the moon, this time to stay. Well, if you look at the SpaceX's capability versus Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin capability, Elon's much far more advanced. You know, sending a couple of old dudes, up 61 miles and coming back down after two or three minutes of weightlessness, that's not going to space, guys. That's not going to space. For me, that's just, taking a glorified airplane and sending it a little bit higher. For me, going to space is leaving the Earth, okay, and being in orbit for at least one or two orbits around planet Earth. That's going to space. So as far as I'm concerned, and even Branson, he didn't go to space, guys. He also just went up, they went up there, they farted around for two or three minutes, weightless, and now they're astronauts. That's not an astronaut, come on. Basically, they just took a glorified airplane that created 3 Gs, 3 Gs on them. They went a little bit higher than most people. But that's not going to space, guys. Leave the planet Earth, rotate around the planet Earth at least one or two times, then come back down to Earth. Spend at least an hour or 2 hours outside of planet Earth, and then we can call you a spaceman. So I think this is really a nothing burger. Nothing's going to happen. Worst case scenario is NASA will sign with Jeff Bezos and Blue Origin and let them compete for some kind of lunar lander. But SpaceX is far advanced, has more capability right now, and the product is much more sustainable. And it's the product. And it's a product that has been designed, and the original concept is to leave planet Earth and go far and beyond. Where Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin concept was to send rich people to go up 62 miles for 3 seconds of weightlessness and come down and cash a check. So, the whole thing is kind of different. So you guys can beat me up in the comments, but that's what I think. So this is a real nothing burger by Jeff Bezos. Elon, if you're watching this video, Elon, I support your brother. You are the man. You're taking us to space, and we're going to Mars, and we're going to put the Doge, a physical Doge, on the moon. And not only that, we got this Starlink project that we're gonna, put satellites all around the Earth to offer high-speed internet to all the remote areas. This is fantastic. This is giving back to the community. We don't hear about Jeff Bezos doing that, right? Come on, Elon, he's got the vision. We're going to Mars, Elon. We're going to Mars, 2050, as per plan. We're gonna start colonizing the moon, and the moon colonizing Mars, and the moon will just be a space station. It'll be the starting point of our journey to Mars. So, forget about Jeff Bezos, Elon. We got your back, brother. We love your brother. You're taking the Doge to the moon. And if you think that Elon's going to be taking the Doge to the moon, smash a like, subscribe right now. I love you guys. That. So let's jump into markets. Okay, so let's refresh the market so we can get minty fresh. There we go. It's now minty fresh, you see. Right now, the market cap is at $1.56 trillion, and that's up 0.68% right now. And my Bitcoin dominance is still about the same. It's at 48.4%. Guys, remember, Bitcoin dominance is high right now. That means that 48% of all the capital in the crypto market space is from Bitcoin. All right, and before you were going to see the altcoins actually smash it and go crazy, we're going to have to see the Bitcoin dominance come down, because when the Bitcoin when Bitcoin dominance come down, it means that more money is flowing out of Bitcoin and flowing back into the altcoins. Okay, so that's not happening right now because Bitcoin dominance is too high. So it is what it is. So guys, don't panic, because some people like saying, well, when Bitcoin was at 40,000 last time, the Doge was at 30 cents. Well, it's because of Bitcoin dominance. Okay, people keep keep commenting on that. So please listen up, get the message right. Don't forget to like and subscribe. So right now, Ethereum is at 2,311. So that's okay if you're holding Ethereum. I got a ton of Ethereum, a ton. I got 1,000 Ethereum. I bought at $340. So I'm happy. So it's up up on about 0.5%, and that's 15.7% for the week. Bitcoin's still cruising along at almost 20-25% for the whole week. So that's not too shabby. Not too shabby. Binance coin is up 0.11%. They're still having a hard time. You know, this whole regulatory FUD thing, and I still think people are a little bit running scared with this whole Tether scare and this and that. So let's see how that pans out, huh, guys? And so they're doing what they're doing. Cardano right now is down almost 2%. What's going on with Cardano? They're supposed to be starting their whole smart contract thing. I don't know what's going on with Cardano. They should be up. They shouldn't be down. We need to check. Let me check the news and come back to see what's going on with that. And they're up only about 7.5%. So my Doge right now is still kind of flatline, which is a good thing. Consolidation, and it's around 20.257. So 0.2057, and that's up about 7% over the last 7 days. So guys, it's, you know, don't worry about it. Everything's looking pretty good. You know, don't worry about Jeff Bezos. He's not going to take our glory. He's not going to take the Dogecoin from the moon. He's not going to do it. And you know, once again, don't forget, you guys remember this, right? The Tether, right? Remember, Tether's under a cloud right now. Tether's absolutely on a cloud right now. They're being investigated by DOJ for, you know, this and that. So just keep an eye on things, you know. But Circle or UDC, remember, they're doing pretty good. They want to go public, and 64% of UDC is backed by US dollar and on the treasury bill. So guys, I think it's a better alternative. It's not financial advice, guys. So let's just jump into the OG Crypto Daily Trade Signals portfolio in the house. So let me give a refresher here, so we got a minty fresh results here. Let's see. Oh, we're up. So yeah, from lunchtime, we were only around about 7.74%. We're actually up a little bit more, guys, so that's pretty good. So right now our portfolio is at $5,416, so that's really peachy keen. So we're up total profits 8.26%, and that's $417. So remember, this portfolio, Daily Crypto Trade Signals portfolio, is for educational entertainment purposes. If you choose to copy that, you copy at your own risk. This is a full disclaimer. This is not financial advice. So guys, don't panic. Don't worry. Everything's beautiful. All right, guys. So let's, a couple more things. Guys, this is my Twitter. I got 46,000 subscribers. And you know, I've only got 1,190 followers. Come on. What's the problem? Do the math, guys. Support the OG in the dog pound. Guys, please go to my Twitter right now and subscribe. When I wake up tomorrow morning, I want to see this at least 2,000, okay? Supporty. Don't forget to smash the like, subscribe, and don't forget to follow me. Don't forget to check out my links. Don't forget to subscribe, smash the likes again. Check out my links, support the channel on Patreon. We have Patreon. We have Buy Me a Coffee on Ko-fi.com. And remember, all of this goes to charity. Help feed the kids in Vietnam. The orphans are hungry. Check out the NFT collection. You're going to love it. Become a channel member, guys. That's really important. Get some free stuff. Check out the free charting tool. And don't forget to check out my shop. Also, I got a lot of cash backs. I got Luno. If you sign up with Luno, you get 10 pounds. Binance, you get 5% cash back. Hobbit, 10% rebate. Also, Swissborg, you get $25 sign-up bonus. Swissborg is not available for U.S. customers, so if you're outside of the U.S., definitely check it out. Celsius, this is where you can earn very high APY on your deposit. You get $30 signing bonus. And a good thing about Celsius, I've been using it for years and years and years, and the thing about it is you get high APY interest, and if you want to send your currency off their platform, they pay the transfer fees. So that's really good. So guys, check out my merch. I got bags, hats, t-shirts. I got all sorts of stuff. I got the mug. My favorite item is the mug. Check out the mug. Check out the Muggy Mug mug. And yeah, get it. And you can choose all these different designs for the mug. Check out the merch, guys. All the stuff for merch goes to charity. So guys, once again, thank you for being here. I love you guys to death. Woohoo! And be blessed. Go with God. Walk with God. Spread a little love. Hashtag Doge spreading love. I love you guys. See you in the next one, 12 o'clock. Woo! Let's get it. I'm so fired up. Let's get it. Doge to the moon, guys. Wow!